We therefore unanimously recommend that the sentence of death should be imposed upon Anthony Kirkland.
Two death sentences for the serial killer who murdered two women and two teenagers. The breaking news came within the past hour. Evening, everybody. I'm Jack Atherton.
And good evening. I'm Cherie Pallello. The jury in the Anthony Kirkland case decided that he should die for his crimes. News says John Lundin is live at the courthouse for our number one story tonight. John, you were there as this was handed down.
Yeah, Cherie, the jury took about the same amount of time to decide that Anthony Kirkland should die for his crimes as they did to decide his guilt. About 4 hours, the jury took a fresh air break around 3:20, came back and sent word that they were ready. And when they came in the courtroom, it was the death decision. Anthony Kirkland said nothing as he left court. A few jurors dabbed their eyes. And afterwards, we spoke with both prosecutor and the defense about the outcome.
What he did to Kasani and Esme is unthinkable. And, well, the jury did absolutely come to the right decision here.
Was he expecting death?
He thought that it would be very tough to avoid the death penalty, but he was certainly cooperative with us and tried to help us as much as he could.
Is this the toughest case you've worked on, though?
Every case is the toughest case I've worked on. Just depends on which one I'm sitting at. Yeah, but this is definitely, this has been the hardest one because of the circumstances and the evidence.
And even as defense lawyers gave closing arguments earlier today, they had told Kirkland to expect a death decision. They reached the point of punishment today after a punishing case bloated with horrific details. The lawyers representing Anthony Kirkland made their life or death argument, telling jurors they're not asking them to cut Kirkland a break because he doesn't deserve one.
He's not getting out. No matter what you do today, that man's not walking out of prison.
The reality is what they fixed on, the reality of life without parole and what it means. Prosecutors seized on another reality, Kirkland's ruthless violence on helpless women and young girls, like 14-year-old Kasani Crawford, like 13-year-old Esme Kenney, whose hands dug into the dirt as her life was choked away.
At that point, she's no longer begging that man to let her live. She's begging that man to let her die.
Kirkland told the jury yesterday he didn't deserve to live, but asked for his life to be spared. Jurors were reminded to be true to the oath they took, not the emotion that could overtake them.
If you feel that life is appropriate, say it. This isn't a mob mentality. You don't have to like Anthony Kirkland. Who would?
But to the county's top prosecutor, the scale of what he did weighed against his own words to the jury isn't even close.
The human carnage caused by this man is almost unimaginable.
Some members of Esme Kenney's family were here for the decision. No one from Kirkland's family was. They were notified, but they chose not to be here. Formal sentencing for Anthony Kirkland in 2 weeks. Live at the courthouse, John Lundin, News 5.